हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम ऑन माय यूट्यूब चैनल माइक्रोबायोलॉजी बाय संतोष नपते। फ्रेंड्स, फ्रॉम लास्ट मंथ आई हैव स्टार्टेड द मेकिंग ऑफ वीडियोस ऑन डिफरेंट स्किल्स एज वेल एज नॉलेज व्हिच इज इसेंशियल फॉर द इंटरव्यूज ऑफ माइक्रोबायोलॉजी रिलेटेड जॉब्स दैट मे बी इन फार्मास्यूटिकल इंडस्ट्रीज, दैट मे बी इन फूड इंडस्ट्रीज, दैट मे बी इन research institutes. So if you are not subscribed this microbiology by Santosh Napte, kindly subscribe this channel so that you will get notifications of upcoming videos. Friends, in today's lecture we are going to see about the standard operating procedures for calibration of different pharma instruments, and here we are going to see about the SOP or standard operating procedure for calibration of BOD incubator or bacteriological incubator. That calibration, it is the very important role of microbiologist in any microbiology related industries. So that's why watch this full video and subscribe this channel, because from today we are going to see about the calibration of different instruments which are used in pharmaceutical industries. So one by one we are going to see that, and our today's instrument, that is bacteriological incubator or BOD incubator. So before going further, we will see this slide here, that is in next session or in next lecture we will see about the role of HVAC system in pharmaceutical industry. That HVAC, it stands for heating, ventilation and air conditioning. That is heating, ventilation, air conditioning system, and that also plays the very important role in maintaining of the quality pharmaceutical products. So don't forget to subscribe this microbiologist by Santosh Napte. I am telling again here, so you will get notifications. So the first thing is here, what is this calibration, validation and qualification? So calibration means it is a set of operations that establish under specified conditions relationships between values which are indicated by an instrument of a system for measuring the, for example, weight, temperature or pH, and recording and controlling or the values which are represented by a material measure and the corresponding is known values of a reference standard. That is called as calibration. So simply, calibration, it is the operations or the procedures which are used for the whether that particular instrument is working properly or not, or whether it is giving the result correct or not. So that is called as the calibration, and it is a very important step in the pharmaceutical industry or other industries. Second concept is here, that is called as validation. So what is validation? Validation is an action of proving and documenting that any process, procedure or method actually and consistently leads to the expected results. So that is called as validation. And this validation, it is a documented evidence to and which is done to prove the consistency of the expected results of any procedure, process or method. So that is called as validation. Then next concept is here, qualification. So qualification is the action of proving and documenting that any premises, system or equipment are properly installed, and that particular premises, system or equipment, it works correctly and it gives the expected results. That is called as qualification. And this qualification is a part, or actually it is the initial stage of validation process, but the individual qualification steps, it does not constitute the process of validation. It is the initial stage. So So we can say that qualification, it is the initial stage and it is a part of a validation process. So these are the three concepts which are very important. One is the, that is calibration. Another one was the, then second one is your validation. And third one is this qualification. So the next concept is here, what is mean by these SOPs or standard operating procedures? So these SOPs or standard operating procedures, it is a written procedure for any process or for any system, and that is followed during the operation of that particular system or operation of that particular equipment. For example, if you are using the pH meter in your laboratory or in that pharmaceutical industry, then there is a one set of steps is there or procedures are there that must be followed by that particular person to check or to determine the pH of a media or that particular material. And that procedures which are followed, that is, these are the standard procedures for the operation of that particular instrument or for the operation of that particular equipment. So that's why that procedures are called as standard operating procedures. And when you follow these SOPs or standard operating procedures for particular instrument, then and then only it will give the correct results. So this is about the SOP. Now these are the different list here that we are going to see in incoming or upcoming video lectures, that is SOPs for calibration of slit, then SOPs for incubators. Here today we are going to see that, then SOPs for the calibration of auto titrator, then SOPs for calibration of pH meter, SOPs for calibration of HPLC column oven, then SOPs for calibration of hardness tester. So these are the list of some instruments and their SOPs that we are going to see. Today we will see about the standard operating procedure for the calibration of BOD incubator. So all of you know this use of this incubator or BOD incubator in our laboratory, but what are the SOPs or standard operating procedure? It means which are the different standard steps or procedure for the operation or use of this BOD incubator. So these are the procedure for the calibration of incubator. So the first step is here, ensure that the material under the test not to be disturbed during the calibration procedure. So that you have to take care here, whatever that material or test material here, that should be not, that should not be disturbed during the calibration process here. Second step is here, calibration of the incubator, it is carried out by 5 PT100 probes which are placed on 4 corners and one in the center of that incubator chamber. So at the 4 corners there are 4 PT100 chambers, that is that sensors or that probes are placed, and one is placed in the center of that incubator chamber. Then for calibration of incubator, you have to scan the all 4 PT100 probes, that PT stands for the platinum probes, and that by pressing the scanner key which is present on the universal controller of incubator, and that is for 24 hours. After scanning, you have to take the printout of that temperature which is maps the 24 hours duration just by pressing the print key present on the universal controller. Now here the probes which are used or the sensors which are used for the calibration of incubator, these are called as platinum 100 probes. So in this platinum 100 probes, that PT, it is the symbol or chemical symbol for the platinum. So that is that sensors or that probes, these are made up of platinum, and that sensors or the second part, that means here 100, it is nothing but the resistance of the sensor or that device at 0 degree Celsius. And in this case, that is in platinum 100 probes, the resistance is 100 ohm. Okay, so this is about the that PT100 probes or the sensors which are used for the calibration of incubator. Next step is here that we have to take the print of this temperature mapping of 24 hours duration. Next one is here that record the minimum as well as maximum temperature which is occur or observe during this 24 hours temperature mapping. And then you have to record them in calibration record by using the one chart, or that is called as the annexure 1. So whatever that temperature will be there, minimum temperature, maximum temperature during that 24 hours of temperature mapping, that we have to record in the annexure 1. And then observe that all the temperature values are within the plus minus 2 degree Celsius tolerance limit, which is to the set temperature value. And frequency of calibration of this BOD incubator, it is yearly once, that is in 1 year you have to calibrate it at least one time of that BOD incubator, or you have to calibrate that BOD incubator as per requirement. Now this is the chart or that format which is called as annexure 1 format, and that is for the, for example, calibration record of BOD or bacteriological incubator. So here asset ID number, then make, that is the name of company here of which that instrument or that BOD incubator is made, reference SOP number, then model number. You have to fill all these things here. When you are working as a quality control microbiologist or in pharmaceutical industry, then you have to keep the documentation or record of all these calibration of instruments. Then date of calibration here, on which date you have calibrated that particular or BOD or bacteriological incubator. Then next due date, because that calibration it is done at least once in a year, so you can write here next due date. Then frequency, it is yearly. Then probe number, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, because we are using platinum 100, and 5 probes are here, 4 placed at the corners and 1 at the center. Then set temperature value. Set temperature value we have to set here, and that you have to note down here. Then after that, observe temperature, minimum temperature, maximum temperature. So that is within the 24 hours of mapping temperature period. And here observed by, so who observed that particular temperature within that 24 hours, the name of that person should be here or that. So what is the remark here? The calibration procedure of instruments are within tolerance limit or out of tolerance limit and gives satisfactory or not satisfactory results. And here there is a calibrated by, the name of that person and the sign, then date of calibration, then here reviewed by and date of that review here. So in this way or in this format, you have to keep the record of that calibration of this, for example, BOD or bacteriological incubator. Okay. So friends, watch all this video, and if you are not subscribed to this Microbiology by Santosh Napte, kindly subscribe this channel. Thank you.